This fall, we have a special program to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month, which is September 15th to October 15th. So the students and I have done some research and come up with a program of music by Latin American composers from six different regions, six different countries. I guess Puerto Rico doesn't quite count as a country by itself. So six regions. All the students have worked very hard on this and done some research about their pieces, and you'll hear more about each individual work from them. Please help me welcome the piano studio. Is this working? Oh, okay. Hello, everybody. I hope you are enjoying your afternoon, and I hope you enjoy this Latin American themed concert that we have. Today, I'll be starting with a piece by a guy named Heitor Lobos from Brazil. This is from a larger piece, a larger set of works called, in my American tongue, Ciclo Brasileiro. This piece is Impressos Cerasquielas, or Minstrel Impressions. A little bit about Heitor Lobos before we continue. He was actually a wandering musician after a disagreement within his family. And as he did, he picked up many different folk tunes and folk ideas throughout his life. And you can hear it in his music. Although it is very dynamic, very virtuosic, and at times dissonant, it still holds those folk tunes that they know that in real. I hope you all enjoy. I hope I know where to put the mic.
Thank you. Henry Banta, and tonight I'll be playing for you Heitor Villa-Lobos' Alma Brasileira, which means Soul of Brazil. The piece opens mournfully, very sad, but this is then contrasted with sections of great lyricism and also of great intensity. And throughout the piece can be heard characteristic Brazilian rhythms. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi, my name is Colin Aguirre, and today I'm going to be performing a Latin American piece by a Venezuelan composer named Diana Franklin. I was researching Latin American piano pieces when I stumbled across this piece called Joropo, and for the life of me, I could not find the sheet music for it online, but I really was determined to play this piece. So I commented on the YouTube video that I watched, and luckily the teacher who performed it was nice enough to email me back, and she sent me a handwritten manuscript of the piece. So I took that manuscript and put it into a MuseScore program so I could read it and play it for you all today. And I really enjoyed this piece, so I hope you do too. Thank you.
Teresa Carreño's immense musical talent was apparent at a young age. She was born in Caracas with her father as her first teacher. And though he had been studying music his whole life, he quickly realized he would not be able to keep up with the rapid progression of his daughter. And seeing her immense musical potential, they moved to New York. And a year later, she had 12 sold-out shows and soon traveled the world performing for thousands of people, including Franz Liszt, Saint-Saëns, and Abraham Lincoln. This extremely chauvinistic ballade is an astoundingly gorgeous piece, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. I'm a composer. I'm from Puerto Rico, and it is my mission to recover a lot of the classical music that hasn't been published there before. I went to Puerto Rico this summer, and I was able to recover around 500 pieces of music. But more interestingly, I was able to meet a composer who's alive right now. I was able to go to his home. His name is Luciano Quiñones. He's in the bulletin. And I will be playing one of his pieces today. He was going to watch a live stream possibly today, but as the hurricane passed yesterday, I only wish he's doing okay right now. So I hopefully you will enjoy this piece. Thank you very much.
Thank you. performing Ernesto Lacona's Malagueña. He was born in Havana, Cuba, and he was alive during the 1950s and 60s. So there are actual recordings of him playing this piece, which is interesting because what he plays in those recordings don't exactly match up with what's on the sheet music. And I think that might be because the piece sounds very virtuosic, so a lot of it was probably improvised. There's also orchestral and band arrangements of this piece, which works really well because of the bass sound it has. And it's his most famous work, part of his Suite Andalusia. And the title is a type of dance, which you can hear in the rhythms, and I had a lot of fun practicing it.
Thank you. So the piece that I'm going to play is Romanza de Amor by Manuel Ponce, and this piece in English is Romance of Love, and this was written in 1912, which for Ponce and Mexico was a very conflicting time, because at the time it was a civil war, which actually prompted Ponce to move to Cuba. So this song is pretty much dedicated to the struggles of that, and his love for his country, and his wife. So, thank you.
Thank you. Hello. Today I will be performing Alberto Ginastera, his 12 American Preludes. Alberto Ginastera was born in Buenos Aires in 1916 and graduated from the Williams Conservatory in 1938. He was very prolific in that time, and so much so that he showed so much promise that he was invited to Tanglewood in America, where he studied under Aaron Copland. And upon his return to Buenos Aires to teach now at the Williams Conservatory, he had many great students, among them the great Piazzolla. So I really hope you enjoy this.
Tonight, I will be playing Danza del Gaucho Matreo.
which can be translated as Dance of the Outlaw Cowboy by Abepo Hingstead. Now, if that is any inclination of what is to come, then you'll know you are certainly in for a ride. Tempo, rhythm, harmonic, and atonal melodies are used to bring this piece to life. It's filled with motion, and it's really a fun piece to play. So I hope you enjoy.
Good evening. The two pieces that I will be playing tonight are two intermezzi by Manuel de Ponce. Something that's very interesting about him is that he wrote for, at one point, a combination of instruments that's not very often seen with guitar and harpsichord that actually Dr. Jones and then Dr. Robinson performed here a few years ago. The first intermezzi kind of has this very sentimental feeling and just lets you really reminisce about life. And then the second one has this very mystical, magical feeling, like you're walking you're walking through some type of force, and it's really cool. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Tonight I will also be playing a piece by Manuel Ponce, his Balada Mexicana. Written in 1915, this piece takes inspiration from romantic composers such as Chopin, who is also famous for his ballades and Liszt. Ponce is also known for incorporating elements of Mexican folk music, which you will hear in the opening melody of this piece and later throughout.
Thank you.